Hello students, welcome to the class. I'm Yogita. Our subject is nutrition for nurses, and today we are going to discuss about types of therapeutic diet. You all know that a therapeutic diet is nothing but we are making some modification in a diet, mainly in the normal diet, so that we are able to meet the requirement of a diseased person, one who is suffering with certain disease or illness. Now, we also know the concept of diet consistency. That means when the person is suffering with the disease, he is able to eat normal food, then it is okay. In case if he is not able to take this normal diet, that solid diet what we are taking, in that case we are bringing some changes, modification in that diet, then that is called diet consistency. So today we'll discuss now important types of diet. Now, important types of diet, mainly there will be three type of diet: normal diet what we are eating, solid diet, soft diet, and liquid diet. Now, this normal diet or solid diet means normal food what we are taking, whatever the solid, which hard food what we are chew and swallow and eat, such foods are comes under this solid food or normal diet. Generally, like if you are stable, if you are able to eat, you are having some disease, but still you are able to eat such kind of food which is strong, which you can chew and eat, then there is no harm, there is nothing to bring any changes in your diet, then we can provide that. That is called solid diet. This is one different case. Now, soft diet. Here, the person who is not able to eat this solid diet, then we need to bring the changes in diet consistency. And here, we are providing soft diet. These soft diets are what I can say, it's overcooked, which made it a little more soft so that it will be easy for the patient to chew and swallow, and there is no much stress on your stomach, that it doesn't require much mechanism of digestion, easily it get digested, easily we are able to meet your nutritional requirement. And these soft diets are recommended when the person is having a problem with the GI system, problem with their mouth, they are not able to chew and eat, when they are having any kind of a disease like acute post-operative phases, we can give this soft diet. And this soft diet do not include any kind of raw food, raw fruits, fiber, spices and condiments. These diets are regularly food what we are doing, and it is regularly cooked, but taken care that it has cooked well so that it become more soft, easy to eat. Now, soft diets include ganji, milk, congee water, fish, soup and various fruit juices what we are preparing. Okay, so this is all about your soft diet. Next, liquid diet. The consistency is, this will be in a liquid form. As you all know, it is in a liquid form. Now, here again we can see two type of liquid: clear liquid diet, full liquid diet. Now, clear liquid diet, they are more kind of watery forms. They clear in their state and very easily we can feed. I can give an example that you will understand. Clear liquid diet like tea, coffee, barley water, ragi water, kanji water, or else tender coconut water, okay, jeera water, see such kind of watery kind of consistency, then that is called a clear liquid diet. Actually, it is not good for giving them for a long time. It is not able to meet all the nutrition requirement, but initially when you're not able to give any kind of food, then we can give this clear liquid diet. Now, these are given in case of they're having temporary illness or acute diarrhea, or else they're having the post-operative phase, immediately 1 or 2 days we can give this clear liquid diet. The second one is full liquid diet. That means this full liquid diet is going to replace this clear liquid diet. Here it is full. That means full of vitamins, minerals, nutrients, whatever you want, that will be present in this. That will be present in this. Now, this full clear diet is, it's just like a fruit juices, kanji, which you mixed and prepared the kanji juice, you made a thick soup, and milk and milk items, what you have prepared, milk shake, such kind of items. Now, this clear fluid, clear full liquid should be free from cellulose and condiments. You should not have any, what is that, strong smell or taste. Okay, now this clear fluid, not clear fluid, this is a full fluid diet. It's going to replace this clear fluid and it is help to meet all the nutritional requirement of an individual. Now, for whom we can give this full fluid diet? If the person is having any GI problem, GI cancer, they're not able to chew and eat the soft food, we can give a NG tube feeding for a long time, then we are giving this full fluid. If they're having unconscious, they're not able to eat orally, they undergone for a surgery and long time they are not able to eat, they are having lot of other problems, severe burns, severe diarrhea, they cannot eat, they are not having that stamina to eat, then we are giving all this clear full fluid diet so that we are able to feed the patient, we are able to meet the nutritional requirement of a patient. So this is all about type of diet, solid diet, soft diet, fluid diet, liquid diet. In liquid diet, clear liquid diet and full liquid diet. I hope you understood. Please go through, please read again and you'll understand, you'll get a better understanding. Solid diet means whatever the normal food we are eating, rice, curry, chicken, biryani, everything. Soft diet is well cooked potatoes, vegetables, the food, overcooked rice. They are very soft to eat. We can easily mix and you can easily have. Liquid diet, in that clear liquid diet like lime juice, lime water, jeera water, kanji water and tea, coffee, other beverages. Then full liquid diet. Full means which contain all the vitamin, minerals, nutrients, everything like milkshake, milk, thick kanji water, fruit juices, soups, such kind of food items. I hope you understood. Please keep reading and keep watching. I'll meet you in the next class with a new concept. Thank you all.